Hello there guys, and welcome to Mad Doc Minis. So having lots of fun here in this video, I'm building a gigantic space marine that's going to tower over his brethren. Basically, he's going to be a freak of nature, an anomaly, some kind of quirk of gene seed and individual characteristic has made him what he is. And he's had to have a suit of armor specially made for him out of this and that, any bits that can be scavenged from other marks of armor and Terminators and dreadnoughts. So that's the idea behind it. Now, I'm doing a bit of a scale check here with another Primaris miniature, just to get a sense if I'm on the right track. As you can see in the footage, I've used Centurion legs. The boots are actually from a Bulgrin, or at least the kind of toes are, the toe caps. And I've actually attached a Primaris torso on top as well. Now, I've attached the butt plate from the Centurion kit as a groin protector here, which works quite well. And at the rear here, I'm just kind of chopping off these servos on the outside of the ankles. I'm going to leave the knee ones, so I think they look fine. Next up is the addition of this armoured plate from a dreadnought. This is on the kind of ankle armour of a dreadnought, and it's actually being mounted upside down here because that fits really nicely. The heraldry adds a nice bit of needed detail as well. Now, moving on, we've filled in some gaps with some milliput there, and we've added these plates, which are from a dreadnought as well, the Blood Angels dreadnought, the wrist armour on that. These are great, and I actually use a few more of those on the build yet to come. So fast forwarding, we've added a lot on this kind of section here. So the rear plates on the feet there are more of those Blood Angels dreadnought armoured plates. We need to kind of chop down the rear part of the legs a little bit more, but I've added some milliput around the feet and around the torso. The arms are from a Bulgrin. They're the only ones that really scaled correctly on this guy, so he's going to have bare arms, which is quite fun. The hammer is from a Death Watch model. It's the biggest hammer I actually could find, and that's been pinned in place in what would otherwise have been the riot baton of the Bulgrin. The helmet is magnetised to enable me to change it out later if I change my mind, but at the moment I'm using the Centurion helmet as it's the largest one I can find. But I might do a kind of bare head option, or maybe an aggressor helmet or something, so I can swap that out if I want. This is where I pin the hammer. I don't normally pin things, but that was very vulnerable, so I decided to drill that out and pin it with a bit of wire. The backpack is from an aggressor, and I'm keeping those promethium tanks on because it just adds needed bulk, really. The chest plate is actually a shoulder pauldron from the Centurion kit as well. So, yeah, we're looking pretty good at this stage. Fast forwarding a bit now, I've added some shoulder pauldrons from those same Blood Angel dreadnought wrist armour pieces. I just couldn't find any pauldrons big enough, so I had to improvise. And the armoured plates on the back here are from the Admech Battle Servitors kit. And the addition of a shield made out of a rhino hatch was an inspired moment for me. I kind of like that idea. And then I've added the helmet crest on top of the head there, just to make it look a little bit bigger, because the head's getting a little bit small in comparison to the rest of the marine. So it's definitely coming together and nearing completion. We just need to add a little bit of battle damage. A sharp hobby knife does the trick on adding damage, and I just kind of scrape and dent and make holes in the armour. I focus on the lower half of the model and the shield. I think these are the areas that will get the most damage. The marine being so tall, I think a lot of enemies would struggle to reach up to the top half, notwithstanding large monstrous creatures and things like that. But it makes sense to me that the lower half would probably get the most damage. So let's move on and look at the paint job. Okay guys, so pretty much done here. Give him a quick paint job. Head's still magnetised, as you can see. So I'm going to probably do a couple of different helmet and head variations so I can swap things out on this. But yeah, he's going to slot very nicely into my homebrew chapter. You've kind of got the rundown on the components already, really, so I won't go through that again. But if you have any particular questions about how he was created or something that I haven't covered component-wise, then just drop it in the comments down below and I'd be happy to answer that for you. The rhino kind of shield here, the rhino door shield, I wanted to give the idea that that actually was the door of a tank. It's not just a shield that's been fashioned for this guy. It's something that's been repurposed because he's so enormous. So the kind of inside of it, I've painted a bit of an off-white colour and weathered that a little bit, because I know a lot of people paint the interiors of their Rhinos and Land Raiders and stuff like an off-white or a cream colour. So that's a little bit of a, you know, bit of a hint towards that. So I think that works nicely. Strategic use of transfers really, really helps to bring some detail in. I'm a big fan of transfers, especially when they're done properly and nicely. My biggest piece of advice there is using Microsol and Microset. I just couldn't live without it now, especially on Space Marine pauldrons and things like that. It's brilliant. So I'm going to go ahead and do some comparisons with this guy now, so you can see how he looks in comparison to Intercessor and an Imperial Guardsman. So thanks ever so much for watching. And if you've enjoyed the content, please consider liking and sharing. It really, really does help my channel to grow. And I do appreciate it, guys. And if you're not already subscribed to my channel, then consider giving me a sub. There's plenty more on the way. Thanks ever so much for watching. And let's go to some direct comparisons now. All right, first of all, let's have a look at this guy in isolation. I'm really pleased with how he turned out. He's definitely not perfect, but neither am I. And the haphazard way he was put together, I think, is very appropriate for the background of this individual. His armour would have to be cobbled together from anything and everything they could find. He's so enormous. But yeah, I'm overall very, very pleased with how it turned out. Let's do a comparison now against a Primaris-sized Marine to get a sense of how big this guy really, really is. So I've chosen an Intercessor for the purposes of this. Wow, look at that. Now remember, Intercessors are already pretty big in the lore. They're about 8 feet or so. So I don't know what that makes our friend here. 10? 12 feet? What do you think? Drop it in the comments if you've got an idea of his actual size in universe. But I'm really happy. I do like the bulk as well. And I think it was the right decision to go with Bulgrin arms, even though they're bare. I kind of like that. I kind of like the barbaric look of those bare arms. And you need that to carry the scale forward. The only thing that's out of scale, of course, is head. But I'm happy with that being smaller. I think it makes sense. The head wouldn't necessarily get big and bulbous as the rest of the body develops. Moving on, let's look against an Imperial Guardsman now. yeah, okay, so the Praetorian looks a little bit like a toddler in comparison. But you know what? I like it. In my head, I think this is how I really imagine Space Marines. They're like almost like abominations, really. They're just huge in my mind. And I like the idea of being able to realise this with a miniature. So I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have, guys. Please join me for another video soon. And do take care. Cheerio.